Sam Loveday has asked how to paint jungle bases, so in today's video we're going to show you how to do that. Now the first thing we'll need to do is actually make the jungle base. Now I've picked a 40mm round base for this, and I've added some bar bracken, but the first thing I did, as you can see on here, I've got some textured paint. Now it doesn't really matter what colour textured paint you use, because we'll be spraying this with Death Guard Green when it's all done. So as you can see, I've scattered a little bit of the bar bracken, just so I can put a model in between those gaps. Now the colours we're going to be using, we'll be starting off with Elysian Green. Now I'm going to pick out probably a third of the leaves using Elysian Green. After that, I'm then going to layer another third of the leaves using Warboss Green. The rest I'll just leave as Death Guard Green. When that's all done, we're then going to shade all over with a Thonian Camera Shade. When that's dry, we'll be using Agrax Surf Shade just around the stems and some of the undergrowth. And finally, we'll do some highlighting by dry brushing Screaming Skull. So first of all, with that Elysian Green, I'm just going to be using my medium base brush for this. Just a little bit of water to that, then we'll just start actually layering that over. So what we're going to do is, like I said, we'll just pick out a third of the leaves. So all I'm going to do is just layer over and just randomly pick. Try and, well, I suppose in some places you can pick ones next to it, but try and just be a bit scattery about it. Don't overthink it too much. Just pick them out randomly. With a bunch of the leaves picked out of Elysian Green, we're now going to use Warboss Green and pick out another bunch. Like I said, I'm only going to do a few more of these. Then I'll leave some actually Death Guard Green as well. Just add a bit of variety, give it that kind of look that you'll see when you look at actual natural fauna and flora. They're not all the same colour green, actually a multitude of different colours. You could always add in some oranges if you wish to, or some reds just to really spruce it up, but for this I'm just keeping them green. With all those leaves now picked out, we're going to use a Thonian Camera Shade, and we're going to shade all over the entire base, including the actual texture on the ground. What this will do is just give it a little bit of definition and really help that texture pop out. Once the Thonian Camera Shade is thoroughly dry, we're now going to use Agrax Surf Shade, and we're going to concentrate this around the centres of the actual bracken itself and also all the way down to the stems. And in some places, just at the very base of the actual brushwork as well, or undergrowth, should I say. Just right at the bottom there, that'll give it a little bit more texture and definition as well. Just change the hue slightly. Once that shade's dry, we're then going to highlight with a dry brush of Screaming Skull. So the idea is just to tickle over those actual leaves and bracken themselves, just gently, just picking out the raised bits. And when you get around to actually doing the texture on the base itself, just put a little bit more pressure on. And there we are, the jungle base is now done. Well, I hope you found that useful, Sam. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.